Seriously, I'm Fresh Fish All-Stars.
Go Fish! The time has come for the debut of Catch Game. The queens choose songs, and the catch? Perform them while doing a celebrity impersonation. Harry Kate campaigned for the win as Donald Trump. Jess Kitten mixed things up with Martha Stewart. Lola Colucci went cuckoo ca-choo-choo for Lady Gaga.
It wasn't her best.
An eight-legged Envy spun a Charlotte look. And Venus was out for blood as Elle Driver.
At first I was like, okay, she's gonna be in top two.
But as her fight scene with Lady Cassandra wore on, it began to look less like she'd be wearing the crown. Meanwhile, Envy was fighting her own battle with Lady Cassandra the White as a fruit-wielding Princess Peach. In a thrilling lip sync, this iconic moment happened. But wait, Envy lip syncing against Lady Cassandra? Never happened. Envy's appearance in Catch Game was part of a dream sequence. In real life, she was sick at home.
That was weird.
But that will not stop us from eliminating someone. Our winner tonight is Harry Kate Olsen. Venus, you are in the bottom two tonight. Lola Colucci, you are in the top two tonight.
I thought I was going to be in the bottom. Well, I figured that I would at least be safe.
And so, in a rematch to Episode 1's lip sync, Venus and Jess squared off again.
She is a fan favorite.
But not even her fans would be able to save her from this shocking twist. The winner, Harry Kate, would be making the elimination.
Venus Catherine DeWilde, congratulations, Jess Kitten.
With the top four queens in place, straws were drawn to determine who would work together in the upcoming Duet Acting Challenge.
Well, I chose Harry Kate because she's been in the top, duh.
I'm super confident with having Jess as a partner.
I'm not a, like, acting queen, like I've never acted before, but you know, like, I can get in character if I have the time to learn a character.
I haven't won a challenge yet, but there's still time in the game.
Since the beginning, I've always put Lola and Harry Kate in the top two. Like, I haven't been able to figure out who that third spot was.
This month on Fresh Fish All-Stars.
It's geared towards pumping the crowd up.
Hey, you guys enjoy the show? Y'all been coming up here for years to steal our routines. And you just love seeing them on ESPN. What are you talking about?
Burr, it's cold in here, so there must be some twirls in the atmosphere. I know you didn't get away from on this show.
We each had, you know, like our own little number.
There's obviously two forces. It is the Toros versus the Clovers. It gives us a chance to be at odds with each other, but then come to be in sync.
We had choreography, we had stunts, we had dialogue.
You guys have to go to Nashville. Did you come up here just to tell me that? Here, I got my dad's company to sponsor you guys.
What is this, hush money?
No. Oh, right, it's guilt money. You pair away in and you sleep better at night knowing how your whole world is based on one big old fat lie. We don't need you.
Why do you have to be so mean? I'm just trying to do the right thing here.
You want to make it right? Then when you go to Nationals, Brandon, don't slack off because you feel sorry for us. That way, when we beat you, we'll know it's because we're better.
I'm Brandon.
him started the night off with a bang. It was good. The crowd loved it, so I was shaken a little bit, but, you know, I still felt really good about my individual performance.
Aren't you Marjorie, when you're the current Miss Georgia World?
What did I say?
I'm Julia Schubert, Suzanne Schubert's
sister. When I was little, I used to watch, on Lifetime, I would watch Designing Women, Golden Girls, Nanny, and Will and Grace. And I remember that scene, and it is a very iconic scene.
I don't really watch TV that much. You know, I'll watch like telenovelas, but I don't know who she is.
And I gather from your comments there are a couple of other things you don't know, Marjorie. For example, you probably didn't know that Suzanne was the only contestant in Georgia pageant history to sweep every category except congeniality. That is not something the women in my family aspire to anyway. It's reported that when she walked down the runway in her swimsuit, five contestants quit on the spot. It's reported that when she emerged from the isolation booth to answer the question, what would you do to prevent war? She spoke so eloquently of patriotism, battlefields, and diamond tiaras grown men with. And you probably didn't know, Marjorie, that Suzanne was not just any Miss Georgia. She was the Miss Georgia. She didn't twirl just a baton. That baton was on fire. And when she threw that baton into the air, it flew higher, further, faster than any baton has ever flown before.
How can you not live for a confetti cannon?
I'll give her the confetti cannon, like that was a nice thing, but she's used it before.
And that, Marjorie, just so you will know, and your children will someday know, is the night the lights went out in Georgia. Marjorie.
I don't know if the word I'm looking for is impressed.
Marjorie, 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 Marjorie.
Like the Madonna song that she put in it, I was like, kind of turn up the club because they were like, oh, whenever Madonna song came out, they were like, okay.
It's probably one of my favorite things I've done throughout the competition.
I was all for it until Madonna came on and I was done. Okay, Madonna to me is like nails on a chalkboard. She's old.
I think Harry Kate is like the girl like to beat right now.
I'm living my truth and it's liberating. Free to be me, we need to be seen. Latinos, Chicanos, Paisanos, Paisitas. My people, mi gente, mi raza, presente. At times I feel the burden of representing mi gente. Pero a cualquier cabrón que no le guste, que se presente. Hey, you're not Mexicano enough. You're not macho enough. You're not Latino enough. Bitch, I had enough. Enough of the hate. Venomous rage like they pull out the gate. The hate they project only leaves them sour. The look on their face cause they see you have power. Let me fly, let me soar, tear me down.
I was upstairs getting ready, and I just heard her mix of like what was happening, and I was really feeling it.
Lola came in hot that night. She really brought it. She looked like a million goddamn dollars. So, I mean, step one.
I don't want to be like someone like, oh, she's not like proud of her culture. She's like trying to like be somebody else that she's not. And on. No, my character is Lola, and that's me. Like, I'm proud to be a Latin drag queen.
It was a very political statement as a Latino in or Latina in Trump's America, like to stand there and, you know, praise your heritage and, you know, who you are in this type of environment. Like, I get why, you know, it went over well, and, you know, it did win me over as well.
My name is Elle Woods.
Legally Blonde, I think, is a really gay movie, so I think it was a smart choice. I don't think she had an edge against me because, though it may be more contemporary, I think what I did was more iconic.
I'm able to recall hundreds of important details at the drop of a hat. Hey, Elle, do you know what happened on Days of Our Lives yesterday? Well, yes, Margo, I do. Once again, we join Hope in the search for her identity. As you know, she's been brainwashed by the evil Stefano.
People live for Legally Blonde. She did the bend and snap. You know, you can't have Legally Blonde without the bend and snap. Apparently, she didn't know her lyrics.
I object.
Was not up close and personal to see it, but knowing Jess and from seeing her in the past, her lip sync is usually pretty tight. So
I was given the criticism that mine wasn't as crisp, and I'm not in any way salty about it, but, and maybe I just have illusions of grandeur, but I think that I actually did my lip sync very well.
Did you ever get in here before?
Yes.
How many? You know, a girl in my story, Tracy Mercy, her better friends. We all tried to tell her about it. How's one of them look for her? But thankfully, that same day, she entered the Beta Delta Pi White t-shirt contest, where she was completely hosed down from head to toe. Jamie, why is it that Tracy Mercy feels gross for women when she got hosed down?
Because they got wet?
Exactly. Because isn't it the first cardinal rule of perm maintenance that you're forbidden to wet your hair for at least 24 hours after getting a perm at the risk of deactivating the ammonium thioglycolate? And wouldn't somebody who's had, say, 30 perms before in their life be well aware of this rule? And if, in fact, you weren't washing your hair, as I suspect you weren't because your curls are still intact, wouldn't you have heard the gunshot? And if, in fact, you had heard the gunshot, Brooke Windham wouldn't have had time to hide the gun before you got downstairs, which would mean that you would have had to have found Mrs. Windham with a gun in her hand to make your story plausible.
thought she did a really good job.
I think it's hard.
I thought we all did a good job that night.
No, Envy's was a little rough around the edges that night.
Like, I was here, backstage getting ready, and like, it was her turn to go, and like, she was not even ready.
What is she doing?
Your mother was this child, and she developed an unusual appetite. Screams, screams, nothing but greens, parts, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and water, and some pickled beans and lettuce. She said, all right, but it wasn't quite, because I caught him in the and my garden one night. He was robbing me, raping me.
Into the Woods.
I've never watched it, so I don't know what it is.
It's very niche.
I love Broadway music, but it just, in terms of like connecting with the audience, I don't really think that it has the power that like a movie or reference or a political reference or something else can have. And so whenever she did Into the Woods, at that, in my mind I was kind of like, that's a little risky.
Bitch, you got the wrong. Bitch, bitch, you got the wrong. Bitch, you got the wrong. Bitch, you slid out my name. You lost your mind and got time for all these games, bitch.
But her mixing in the Todrick Hall thing, I was like, okay, that's relevant. And, you know, it's dance moves playing to your strength. I felt like the crowd was really feeling me, and hey, I got tipped really well. She was a hot mess, sorry girl. But she was a hot mess. I feel like she was being rushed. You know, like she didn't have time to paint her beard, and like she needed more time for whatever she was doing.
One, the cow as white as milk. Two, the cape as red as blood. Three, the hair as yellow as corn. Four, the silk as pure as gold. Before the chime midnight, in 3 days' time, 'tis then the new moon reappears.
I wish I had a little more time in between my numbers. When you're upstairs and getting ready, and you're like, oh God, Jess is on, I'm next. Like, let me try and put this contact in my eye and not mess up my makeup. You know, it's like you start getting nervous, and then it's like you can hear like the clock ticking in your ear. I would have had more time to change if Queen had done her number.
Individual performance I knew was good. I was a little concerned about my performance with Lola.
It turned out really good. Like, the dialogue, I got it like this.
Do you have some sort of businesswoman special?
Well, businesswoman.
From LA.
And you know, some places have like a lunch special for kids.
We don't have anything like that.
Well, then why don't you just give us two burgers and fries and Diet Coke to the room? We're doing to the sun later. For business thing, you know.
Woo! What kind of business do you need?
Okay, I invented Post-its. Actually,
I invented a special kind of glue.
Oh, really? Well, then I'm sure you wouldn't mind giving us a detailed account of exactly how you concocted this miracle glue, would you?
Yeah. Well, ordinarily, when you make glue, first you need to thermoset your resin, and then after it cools, you mix in a hot side, which is really just a fancy schmancy name for any simple oxygenated adhesive, right? Then I thought maybe, just maybe, you can raise the viscosity by adding a complex glucose derivative during the emulsification process. And it turns out, I was right.
I don't believe it. You must be the most successful person in our graduating class.
Uh-huh. And you're not. Bye.
They kind of just stood in one place for a lot of it. And a lot of theirs wasn't really bouncing off of each other. It was a lot of spoken to the crowd.
We had a lot more stuff going on. Theirs was real slow.
A lot of it was standing in place, like standing in the same place.
What the hell is your problem, Christy? Why are you always such a nasty bitch? You get some kind of sick pleasure from torturing other people? I mean, yeah, okay. So Michelle and I did make up some lame story. We only did it because we wanted you to treat us like human beings. But you know what I finally realized? I don't care if you like us, because we don't like you. You're a bad person with an ugly heart, and we don't give a flying fuck what you think. Come on, Michelle. Okay. And, yeah.
Of you, all the things, circles, confusion is nothing new. Touch back, wonders, almost left me. Suitcase of memory, time sometimes you picture me. I'm walking too far ahead. You're calling to me, I can't hear what you've said. Then you say, go through, I fall behind. The second hand unwind. If you're lost, you can look and you will find me.
They did Time After Time as their main song, which is a very slow song to do at the end of the show when everybody is all riled up and drunk.
But I think because we were at the end of the night, we had the advantage of people being drunker and reacting like sort of like with the emotional ties they have to that movie or Time After Time or like the weirdness of what we were doing. So I think that worked to our advantage.
I'd never seen that movie before and I was like trying to learn the character.
Was so much bigger and so much more flashy with lots of fast dancing, and ours was a little more demure and slower.
I thought that like our duet performance would possibly knock one of them into the bottom.
We had so much more going on than they did.
It was more of like a performative, like, you know, this is the reference we're making, we're spouting these lines, and then
Jess has been in the bottom, and like she only has one challenge.
I think that Julia Sugarbaker and Elle Woods' monologues are on the same level. I was feeling really confident.
Somebody's gonna go home, but I
it's not gonna be me.
Indeed, the judges ruled Lola the winner of the challenge.
She did a great job. She deserved the win.
I agree that Lola should have, I feel like Lola should have been, like, the winner overall.
That's my second win. So I'm excited. And Amy Soto sent me a message saying, I'm so proud of you. And I'm like,
oh. Harry Kate and Lola have never been in the bottom.
Harry Kate has the star of her spot to be in, like, in the top two or, like, or winning.
Maybe in their group performance, I think Envy was stronger.
I honestly don't understand why they didn't get the criticism that theirs was very, like, mood-lowering or energy-lowering. I ended up in the bottom.
What is this? Like, give me something like today. It's like, girl, that was a boring ass song.
Whenever I came out, I made myself like a coming out playlist, and it had that song on it. So I had like, you know, a lot of emotions from that period of my life tied to it. And so I just channeled that whenever I was singing. You know, it was very emotional. Sorry, girl. I had to lip sync in Broadway night. I had to lip sync against Venus, and then I had to lip sync against Envy.
I think that the lip sync between the two of them carried hardly any weight. Envy's performance was not as strong as Jess's individual performance.
I think I've had a better track record than Envy.
Oh god, that song was horrible.
The person going on to the top three next month is... Just kidding.
For all of my life, I've always been very quiet and reserved and, you know, shy. And this is one of the first outlets that I've ever had, like, creatively.
I had to go home at some point. Winning isn't everything to me, because, you know, some of the best queens don't win drag race, Shangela. Even if I'm not in the top, you know, I still have gained a valuable experience in the world of drag. Being in Fresh Fish Season 2, and Fresh Fish All-Stars, it's just taught me a lot. It's kind of like drag college. I think I've had some really good performances. I've been really proud of all of mine. You know, I come up with them. I make my mixes. You know, I make my costumes and everything. And I put a lot of work into each one.
Isn't that right?
Yes.
This challenge, I'm still going to take on all those things that I've, you know, picked up along the way, but like it's gonna be like just kitten material. I'm just going into it doing what I want to do. It's a theme that a lot of people have, but I know some people have said that they've wanted, you know, done here.
I feel like I have a good idea to draw in a crowd that maybe we don't necessarily always appeal to. What I do really takes you out of what you're experiencing in that moment and I make you focus on me. Making an experience happen, that's what I'm always aiming to do, is to really make you react to something. You know, I've been here for 3 years. I've been at every party. I've been here every weekend. And so I think that plays to my advantage.
When I host a party, you know, I like to go out and like talk to people. Like, I love to be humble and dragging. You know, like, I'm not trying to be like, bitch, I have this sickening costume. Like, you're letting me know. I know I have the like good shit, but I'm always gonna be humble. You know, I love talking to people when I'm in drag. When I'm on a drag, I'm just like, kind of weird talking to, like, strangers.
Fresh Fish is filmed in front of a live studio audience every second Saturday, only at Club Sway. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and catch every episode. The winner of Fresh Fish All-Stars will receive a prize package including custom-made jewelry from Myriad of Mischief and a handcrafted leather good from Ophalian Leather. To audition for Season 4 of Fresh Fish, send a brief introductory video to Sway on Facebook.
Yes, my God is yes, my God is real, my God is real, or I can feel you feel him in your soul. Yes, my God is yes,
yes.
My God is real,
my
God is real, or I can feel. I can feel
him
in my soul.
All right.
Making an experience happen.